assessment very quickly. I want to conclude this lecture today with a little bit on how we actually determine whether a person has a sexual dysfunction or not. When is it a problem? We should look at the norms, first of all. We should look at the norms. So, for example, Kinsey back in 1953. Now, I report an old statistic here because it's a classic. And this has been replicated in recent times. But Kinsey was the one who really got the ball moving here. He said that 20% of adult women report rarely experiencing orgasms, and 10% don't have one at all. Now, on to men, over the page. We'll finish this last page and then we'll go. Kinsey, 1948, I mean, these are real pioneers like Masters and Johnson, said, well, you know, a lot of people think they have sexual performance dysfunction, but let's find out. How can you say someone has a dysfunction if you don't know what is the norm for most people? So, you know, this is relevant to this day. This wasn't just in 1948 where people had misinformation about what the norms were. I sometimes, when I check out in a grocery store, can't help but notice, you know, those magazines on the side, like Cosmo magazine, right, saying things like, you know, how to have sex with your man any time of the day or night and make him last 4 hours. And I look at this and I say, you know what, this is absurd. This is ridiculous. Who's learning from all this? Well, let's look at it. Let's look at the norms. The mode is 40% of men ejaculate in less than 5 minutes. That's the mode. And 34% between 5 and 10 minutes, and only 9%, less than 10%, last more than 30 minutes. So I'm sorry, if you come and tell a clinician, well, you know, I lasted 4 hours. I'm sorry, you're a mutant. It can't be anything else. Or you're taking some kind of steroid, which backfires.